Christian Smith Johnson. Batting fifth, behind the plate, number 25, Marshall Maynard. Batting sixth, playing third base, number 8, Jackson Strickland. Batting seventh, playing shortstop, number 4, Cesar Ibarra. Batting 8, the designated hitter, number 3, Tanner Harris. Batting 9, playing right field, number 7, Justin Chirinos. On the mound for the Royals, number 10, Isaac Lopez.
Welcome back to the campus of BIRDVILLE High School. Warm-ups are out of the way, and everything except for baseball tonight. BIRDVILLE HAWKS will be looking to do something they haven't done during a district play this season. That's split a series. They'll be looking for win number 20 in just a moment as they go up against the Richland Royals today in the final game of their home-and-home matchup. I'm Mike Davis here with you tonight as the Hawks will be looking to start a new winning streak after taking an L on Wednesday. BIRDVILLE saw their 13-game winning streak snap last night when they fell to Richland 10-0. Nothing went right, nothing got going for the Hawks in the game. I'm sure they'll have to put that in their rearview mirror. Harrison does come in with a 5-5 in their last 10. They're one game up on fourth. They're just ahead of a three-way tie and for the fourth position with Northwest, Lake Dallas, and Colleyville Heritage. They are just one behind Denton for second. Get you the lineups and building positions here in just a moment. So first, the Richland Royals leading off, playing left field is Leo Salas, followed by Sebastian Lopez, batting third is Manny Salas. Cleanup is Christian Smith-Johnson. Marshall Minard catching, batting fifth, Jackson Strickland. Sixth, Cesar Ibarra. Seventh, Tanner Paris and Justin Chirinos round out the lineup. In the outfield for the Hawks, you have Lockett, Brooks, and Sigmund. Around the horn is Martinez, Wyanis, and Showalter at second. Iwano at first, behind the plate. Bush and on the hill for the Hawks is Cameron Ward. Ward comes in 2-1 with a 3.25 ERA, 28 Ks with 19 walks. Got a 1.56 whip, walk hit, innings pitched. First pitch misses high, so we're underway here. Very cool evening, about 68 degrees. The 0-1 pitch misses outside. Strong wind blowing in from the outfield. You're probably hearing that picking up on the crowd mic. Pitch. Routed over to Wyanis. Over to Iwana for the first out. It's going to bring up Sebastian Lopez, the second baseman for the Royals. First pitch in there for a strike. Ward with his first strike of the game. Wind up, goes down low. Check swing did go around. Lopez down in the count, 0-2. Top of the first. It's going to bring up Manny Salas, the first baseman for the Royals. They're going to shade him over to right field. Straight away in the infield. That first pitch misses, curveball down low. Salas could get on that and bring up Christian Smith-Johnson. One-oh pitch, inside misses. Ward goes down on the count, 3-0. Missed out on a couple of pitches inside. Has the glove high when it comes to the stretch. And that pitch is going to miss high, so the Royals have a runner on here with two down in the top of the first. Two out walk to Salas brings up Smith Johnson, the center fielder. Batting cleanup tonight for the Royals. Ward from the stretch, holds his glove up high. Sets, delivers, grounded over to Showalter. Easy play over to first. That'll do it for the first inning. No runs, no hits, one walk. We go to the bottom of the second, or bottom of the first. Our score is zero. Hawks coming up. Welcome back. We head to the home half of the first. Due up for the Hawks is going to be Ben Brooks, followed by Grant Pert, DHing tonight. Will Bush batting third. And catching Nico Iwanu, batting fourth. Lana Martinez, fifth. Corey Lockett, Mason Sigmund, Gabe Juanes, and Alex Showalter round out the bottom of the lineup. Defense for the Royals, Leo Salas in left, Smith Johnson in center, Chirinos in right. Ron the Horn Strickland at third, Ibarra Lopez, Manny Salas at first, from third to first, and Miner at catching. On the hill for the Royals is Isaac Lopez. Brooks steps in there, batting 290 on the year, 10 RBIs, 18 runs scored, 4 doubles. Takes a swing at the first pitch, popped up, shallow center field, under it is Smith Johnson. That's out number one of the inning.
Now batting number 23,
the Skyrockets might be a little tough for the outfielders with the wind blowing in. It's going to bring up Grant Pert. Batting 302, 5 doubles, 11 RBIs, 13 runs scored, and an 817 on base for Hawks. That pitch misses low and outside. Pitch to Pert. Comes inside, misses, 2-0 to count. Good crowd again here tonight, as always. Everybody coming out supporting senior night for the Hawks. As we start winding down the season and get focused on playoff baseball here, that pitch misses down low and inside. So Pert head of the count, 3-0. Trying to get on for Will Bush, who waits on deck. Lopez likes to come from the stretch, and that pitch is going to miss outside. So Pert on four. Scratch that. Click down. That was a ball four. Next strike one. So Pert back in there. Up as he gets the stretch of 3-1. That one misses down low for ball four. So Pert is now on. The one out walk. It's going to bring up Will Bush, the catcher. Bush hitting 414 on the year. Off base plus slugging of 1137. He's got six doubles, seven RBI, six runs scored. Does lead the team in walks at 21, so he does not work a count to get on base. First pitch to Bush. Catches the inside corner, strike one. First is Pert, and that pitch missed down low in the dirt. Not far enough for Pert to go anywhere, so he'll have to hold up at first base. One push. That catches the outside corner for strike two. Side you're leaning that strike or a ball. Push down the count 1-2. That pitch misses inside. Just misses catching Bush on the shirt. To the gun to Bush, and one awaits on deck. That pitch swung on up the middle. LeSean with a single. It's going to bring up Nico Iwanu, first baseman. Iwanu's batting 371, a 992 hops. 23 RBIs on the year, 15 runs scored along with two triples and a home run. Opportunity here for Iwanu to not get some runs. That pitch misses way outside for ball one. Hawks threatening here on the bottom of the first. They were shut out last night, so looking to definitely mount some runs here. That bad taste out of their mouth from last night. Still 19-3-1 on the year, 8-1 in the division. It's good enough for first place over Denton Ryan. Little game of cat and mouse at second base with Pert. Lopez will step off the reel, the hill. So two down now for Bina Martinez. After the pop out to left field. First pitch to Martinez, and the looping curveball misses down in the dirt. The 1-0 pitch to him. Inside again, Bynum batting 313. He has 10 RBIs, 14 runs scored, 5 doubles. Chance for him to stretch out his RBIs total. 2-0 pitch to Martinez. Swung on to left field. Under it is Salas. And and makes the catch, and that's going to do it for the threat in the bottom of the first. Two runners left on, no run scored, and we head to the top of the second. Nothing, nothing, our score. So we head to the top of the second. It's going to bring up Christian Smith Johnson, Marshall Minard, and Jackson Strickland. Excuse me, Marshall Minard's doing up Strickland and Ibarra. Did get a 1-2 out walk in the first inning. Couldn't do much after that, after Johnson got out. So straight back rolls, three innings back of the Hawks, but in a kind of a log jam there. Not much room separating third and third and fourth spot right now, as there's three tie in district play. Vying for that final fourth seed for the playoffs. Cameron Ward now down in the count, 3-1. Strickland to follow Minard, 3-1 pitch. Swung on, foul down the right line. Jump on the inside pitch, just couldn't get the head around the bat quick enough. Spiner back in there, full count to him. Kicks and deals, that pitch is fouled up. Martinez chasing, and banks the cash for the first out of the second inning. Kind of a tough play for Martinez, had to backpedal and track it down, but he's able to make the catch. Bring up Martinez's counterpart, Jackson Strickland, third baseman for the Royals. One down here on the top of the second, no score. Break ball doesn't break, misses high. Again with the 1-0 pitch. That's fouled straight back. So 1-1 to count to Strickland. That pitch misses again.
some issues with his hat up there. Keeps falling off the last two pitches. Strickland will be followed by Ibarra. Two-one pitch, swung on, grounded to Juanes. Over to Iwanu, has to make a stretch for it, makes the catch and the out. First base coach wants to say he came off the bag, but nothing doing. That'll be the second out of the top of the second. Cesar Ibarra steps in, shortstop for the Royals with two down, top of the second. Doesn't cash the corner to the ump's leg. It says ball one. Ward has been going deep in some of these counts early here in the first couple of innings. And that pitch is foul. Count evens out at one. If Ibarra can get on, that'll bring up Tanner Paris, the DH. Ready with the 1-1 pitch, grounded over to Martinez, over to Iwanu. That'll do it for the top of the second. We're gonna head to the home half, the second. Lockett, Sigmund, and Wyans coming up. Welcome back. We head to the bottom of the second. Corey Lockett, Mason Sigmund, and Gabe Juanes do up for the Hawks. Able to put out two base runners the last inning, but couldn't muster up any more offense after that. Hawks still looking to snap his eight-inning scoreless streak this season against the Royals. First pitch, tight to Lockett. So Lockett is batting 333, two doubles, one triple. So takes the 1-0, swung on a miss. It has worked five walks in this season. 1-1 pitch. The visitor side of the field does not like that call, but nonetheless, the ball 2-1 to Lockett. A little inconsistency on the corner so far early in this game. But if it's inconsistent both ways, I guess it's still consistent, so. Lopez from the stretch gets set. 2-1 pitch. Lockett takes the curveball, fouls it back to the left side. Had an opportunity there, came with a curveball. It's kind of hung there up in the zone. Just out a little ahead of it, fouls it off. Mason Sigmund on deck for the Hawks right now. 2-2 pitch. Skips in the dirt. Count runs full for Lockett. Pretty much straight away in the infield and outfield. Off the line at third. Takes the 3-2 pitch and fouls it off to the left side. So Lockett staying alive at the plate. That's going to set with the full count pitch. It's going to miss high. Lockett's on base. A leadoff walk. So Sigmund steps in. He's hitting 349 on the year. Got four doubles, nine RBI, nine runs scored, and four walks. Has an on-base plus slugging of 950. Goes down for that curveball, fouls it off. No outs here in the bottom of the second. Corey Lockett on first base after the leadoff walk. Shows bunt, pulls away in time, but it's called a strike on that corner. Dave Wynas on deck for the Hawks. 0-2 pitch popped up to center. Give it chase to Smith Johnson, walks under it, and then makes the catch for the first out of the inning. Wynans, haven't had much action. He's 2-for-11. He's got two RBI and one run scored. The one down here might be telling him to play a little smart. Try to push a bunt down the line. Shortstop steps in there. Might have wanted to, but he's only had 11 at-bats this season. Takes the first pitch for a strike. Lopez likes to work his curveball in there. Quick throw over to first, and Lockett's back in time. Two or three step lead for Lockett at first. And another quick throw over. He's able to walk back. These are sensing they might be laying down a bunt, trying to keep Lockett closer to first base. Possibly turn a double play here. Pulls back the bunt. Lockett has caught no man's land. Does get back in time, though. Was a close play, but I do think Lockett got his hand back in on the bag. Shut up, Coach with Scott Time have a little discussion on that call over there. Royals led by Steve Foster. Still appeal to call to home base, so hopefully an umpire, they're going to have a little discussion about it. Looked like he did get back in there. Tag was kind of high on the arm. I don't think he's going to go against this infield ump. So there it stands. Is back in there, down in the count, 0-1. See if he shows bunt again here. He does. Gets it down, but had a bat at a funky angle and it caused it to pop up. He'll be swinging here, down in the count, 0-2. A situation where you just want to get the bunt level with the plane there and get the ball down to get the run over to second. And that pitch, curveball, misses down low. So 1-2 the count. Excuse me, 2-2 the count. Showalter waits on deck. Number 9 hitter. Lockett, the lead over at first base. 2-2 pitch. That's chip foul to the first base side. So Wine is staying alive, even in the count 2-2. That 2-2 pitch is way outside, so Wine has worked the count full. Missing on 2 bunt attempts. We actually just missed on 1 bunt attempt. Had to pull back the first one. That was a ball. Pocket slightly there first, and that pitch is down. Oh, they're going to ring him up on that one. Pitch did look low. He'll be down on strikes. Couple minor caught the bottom of the plate. Brings up Alex Showalter. Second base tonight, 4-12. 3 doubles, 13 RBI, and 12 runs scored. First pitch in, curveball grounded over to Ibarra. Bar tosses over to Lopez, and now to do it for the bottom of the second. Head to the top of the third. No score. minutes at the top of the third. Nothing. Our score here. Tanner Paris, Justin Chirinos, and back to the top of the lineup with Leo Salas. Well, the Royals do up here in the top of the third. No sunlight hitting the field. Starting to cool off. And check swing foul ball. Nice shot of the moon coming up over left field. It's like a full moon. I think that's tomorrow. Tanner Paris is DHing tonight for the pitcher Isaac Lopez. Expecting how much pop they do have them playing in the outfield. That pitch is going to be high. 2-1 to count for Ward. Pitch. Grounded over to Showalter. Bobbles it, throws over to Iwano. Gets past to Iwano, backed up by Bush. So Paris will take second on the wild throw. And that throw goes in the left field, but he's not going anywhere. It's being backed up. So the wild throws allows Paris to get to second. Justin Chirinos, number 9 hitter for Royals, comes up. New down here, Renner on second. It's Tanner Paris. Royals trying to ride some of that magic they had last night. Their win over these Hawks. That was played out there in Richland. They moved it from Tuesday to Wednesday because of the weather. That bunt is fouled way back. Kind of decided to bunt at the last second. Kind of results you get if you're too late. Leo Salas on deck. That pitch. Fastball misses up out of the zone. Check a second to 1-1 pitch. Yeah, that's going to be outside again. Been missing in and out. First half of this game. First third of this game. As that pitch comes on inside. So Cal rolls it 2-1. About to talk to him. Happened a couple of weeks ago when I was out here. Had some control issues. Did a little talk, let him know what he's got going and see if it can settle him down or just give him a little second to kind of focus back in on the strike zone. So no down here, top of the third. Leo Salas on deck, Sebastian Lopez in the hole. Right fielder Justin Chirinos heading to count 2-1. Trying to get the Royals on the board here in this scoreless tie. That swung and fouled back. Runs the count full. See if he tries to come back and run something off speed pitch on the inside. Just keep him off balance. The stretch, fastball outside, fouled back. Count's actually 3-2, I said 2-2 earlier. Straightforward that kind of count. Don't want to put them on base with nobody on. That pitch is drove to right field. It's going to fall in for a base hit. Rounding third. Holding up at third is going to be Paris. Rails are threatening now. Runners on the corners after the single by Chirinos. The Royals' first hit of the night. We're back to the top of the lineup. Leo Salas, the left fielder, is due up now. We're batting now. Got an opportunity here with no down. Grounded to Wynas in the first inning to lead off the game. Hold him on the bag at first, so we'll sacrifice the run for the double play here. That play, double play depth, kind of pinching the bag up at second. Bynum and close down the line at third base. Excuse me, yeah, Bynum. Brooks is shading them to right. They're in center field. Just telling Ward to step off the bag, take a second. Pitch count, but Cameron Ward has gone deep on a lot of these counts. Working high pitch, and that pitch, speaking of high, is inside to Salas, able to duck out of the way. Paris around at third, Chirinos around at first. That ground ball is up the middle for a base hit. Paris will come around to score. Back-to-back singles for the Royals, and they take the lead early 1-0 here in the top of the third. Tanner's going to come out to talk to his young pitcher. We're going to take a short break. You're watching BIRDVILLE HAWKS Baseball on Vype Live. So the Royals strike first here on the top of the third after the Salas RBI single. So back-to-back singles for the Royals, Salas and Chirinos. Bunt is pushed foul by Lopez. Lopez was a strikeout victim in the first inning. No outs to her in the third. Royals looking to play for a big inning here. Pitch down low. That's a good chin strap for his hat. Keeps popping off every time he throws the ball. I'm Count using it one, no outs here. Top third, that ball misses low again.
Got to cut a finger to the bullpen. I don't see anybody warming up down there for the Hawks. That 2-1 pitch is swung on. Changed the speed on that one. Couldn't catch up to it, so count evens up at 2. Ward looking for the first out of the third. The Paris reached on by error. Got the second. Went over on the Trino single and scored on the Salas single. That pitch down low in the dirt, full count. Royals looking like they're finding their playoff stride here. Put up 10 yesterday. Lead this one 1-0 and pays off that one. Lopez is on with a walk. Base is full of Royals. Tanner's going to come out and talk to Ward again. Short break. You're watching BIRDVILLE Hawks Baseball on Vype Live. Hi, welcome back. There was a pitch change. Isaac Phelan's going to come in to finish out the third inning as he comes in for Cameron Ward. All three runners are on the books for Cameron Ward. As Manny Salas steps in. Salas walked in the first inning. Takes that pitch outside for ball one. We're to struggle with control issues here. The first couple of innings. Smith Johnson on deck. There are no outs still in the top of the third. That ball's grounded foul. Player, but foul ball. It's a play by Ewan and to come home with it, but umpire blew it. I didn't blow it. Called a foul. to Manny Salas. Torinos, Leo Salas, and Lopez cover the bags for the Royals. Infield is playing in. Play would be to home here. Any ground ball goes to home. That pitch is out. Outside corner for a strike two. So Beeland is ahead of the count, 1-2. Beeland has 20 strikeouts on the year. 21 and gets it. He makes a swing and miss at that one. So one down. Double play would get them out of the inning with minimum harm done. So Christian Smith Johnson steps in as center fielder. Feelings pitched 20 innings. 3-0 record. 1.377 ERA. So he does the job when he does come in there. Curveball swung on a miss. Nice little movement on that pitch. Couldn't catch up to it. Smith Johnson's down on the count. That's the last out of the first inning. 0-for-1 officially today. Just come in with one out here and bases full of Royals. Trying to blow this one wide open here in the third inning. And another off-speed pitch swung on and fouled straight back. Smith Johnson struggling to catch up to it. Back with a fastball here, trying to keep him off balance. Made it from the stretch with the pitch he likes. 0-2 pitch. Curveball fouled straight up. It's playable. Linus under it. Makes the catch for out number two. Looking to get out of the threat here. Marshall Minard comes in, the catcher for Royals. He popped out to Martinez in the second inning. Thielen, first pitch to him. He likes the 0-1 pitch from the sidearm. Comes inside, misses. Count evens at one. Minard can get on. That's going to bring up Jackson Strickland, the third baseman for the Royals. Leading this one 1-0. So the RBI single from Leo Salas brought in Tanner Parrish, who got on by the throwing error for the first base runner of the inning. Curveball. Misses down low. That's a happy about that count, or that pitch, I should say. Yeah, that's made the count 2-1. Two outs here, top of the third. Royals got the lead. And yeah, that pitch is outside, so. Favorable to Minard ahead in the count, 3-1. Nowhere to put him. So we'll have to come back with a challenge pitch here. So 3-1 pitch from Phelan. And that hits the corner for strike two. So count runs full. Runners will be off on the next pitch. Hawks looking to get out of here with only giving up one run in this inning. Chirino, Salas, Lopez, Cover the backs for the Royals here. Full count pitch, that's outside, puts him on. So he'll walk and a run. Chirinos comes around to score. Jackson Strickland comes in now. Royals leading this one by a score of 2-0. Strike to Jackson, that pitch, that runner is property of Ward, so that's two runs on Ward for this inning. One pitch to Jackson, swung on, foul back to the third base side. Strickland grounded out to the shortstop in the second inning. Let's take a crack here to see if he can bring us some more runs for the Royals. Head 2-0, two down here with the bases loaded. Royals looking definitely for some more runs here. That curveball catches the corner for strike three. And that'll do it for the third inning. Two runs, two hits on the third inning. We head to the bottom of the third. You're watching BIRDVILLE Hawks baseball on Vype Live. Brooks leads it off for the third inning for the Hawks, down 2-0. Gonna get some runs here. A 9-inning scoreless streak here against the Royals. Just looking to crack that goose egg and cut into this 2-0 deficit they have here early in the third. Net ball is driven to right field. Going to fall in front of Chirinos. Now Brooks is on with a leadoff single. Good start to the third inning for the Hawks. Graham Pert, Will Bush, Nick Iwanu do up here for the Hawks. Pert walked in the first inning. Got the second on the Wilbush single, but went none further than that. See if they can cause some damage here on the top of the lineup. There's 2, 3, and 4 hitters due up here for the Hawks. It's a pretty head in the count, 1-0, 1-0. Pitch, down low, ball two.
214 in district play for the Hawks. He is getting a base to those six. He's got a 371 on base percentage. He's walked six times. Seven now if you count the one from the first inning. Takes the 2-0 pitch. That's going to be outside. I got to stop calling the pitches early. Let the umpire call it. Pitch is called a strike, so count is now 2-1 to Pert. Yeah, curveball off the middle. That's swung on a miss and still in first base. Second base is Brooks. Brooks moves over to scoring position now. Hit and run action. Swung on a miss by Pert, so he's even in the count 2-2. Brooks over in scoring position after stealing second. Bush waits on deck. Barb shading up the middle, comes back to his normal position. That pitch misses down low. Wanted to wait the full second there. Count full 3-2. Bush waits on deck. The stretch, Isaac, pitch inside, ball four. Will Bush an opportunity here. He's turning up in district play. He's batting 429 in district play. 12 walks, 129 on ops. Three doubles and four RBIs. An opportunity to get his fifth RBI here with Brooks on second, Pert on first. And that's first pitch. Her ball misses. So Hawks looking to answer back at the top of the first when the Royals put up two. They can just get on the board. Get that first run. Hopefully that can open up the floodgates here for the Hawks. Massive runs here. One pitch popped up. Should be playable for Salas. He's hard in. It's going to be caught up by Ibarra. Can't get to it. Falls down. It will get Brooks at third base as he had the tag. It was kind of a no man's land there. Either way, one down. One down now, so runners on first and second. This time, by Bush and Pert. Bush reached on with a fielder's choice there. So that brings up Nico Iwanu, who popped out to left field to end the first inning. Stepping in there for the second time tonight. Swings already in that one. Fouled off to the right side. Pickoff move to a Pert in second. Almost goes in the center field. Nice grab there by Barr to keep it in. Tim on here for a little discussion. We're going to take a short break. You're watching BIRDVILLE Hawks Baseball on Vype Live. Thank you. to action here. Wanu down in the count, 0-1. Burt at second, Bush at first, one down here in the top of the bottom of the third. Hawks trailing this one 2-0, looking to cut into that lead here. Bina Martinez on deck. 0-1 pitch comes in, fouled back again. You want to foul out those inside pitches, get in a little bit early on those. It's down in the count, 0-2. Check a second comes in and again goes back to that same spot, fouls it off, catching the inside of the bat, doing a good job of making contact, staying alive. Oh, 2 grounded up the middle. Lara plays it perfectly. Goes off his chest. Unable to make the play. He was in the right spot. Just couldn't come up with it. It's like a hot caught him off the chest. And everybody advances 90 feet. It's a tough play to make for the shortstop there. We'll give it Iwanu a single on that one. So Hawks now their shot here with the bases loaded. One down. And he hits the outfield, scores a run. Ida Martinez in there. He lined out to left field to end the first inning. Ida takes that first pitch. Curveball breaks early. Misses down low for ball one. I'm looking for the big hit here to break open this. No score here for the Hawks. Martin Lopez misses, 2-0 now. Martinez sitting with a healthy count, 2-0. Corey Lockett, the left fielder, is on deck. 6-0 hitter. Looks at the 2-0 pitch. Off the catcher's mask. Here comes Kurt to home, and he'll score. The Hawks are on the board. Throw this one now 2-1. The pass ball by catcher Minard. That took a bounce and went off his chest. Moved over. Bush to third. Iwanu to second. Excuse me, Iwanu did advance. It would have been a tough play from advance. The ball did bounce to the first base side. But Bush takes over at third. Double play still a factor here since Iwanu is at first base. Martinez is ahead of the count, 3-0. Sure, the signs came into him saying don't swing unless that thing is pipe down the middle. Lopez has struggled to find the strike zone. That pitch misses outside, so he walks the bases back loaded. That's going to be Corey Lockett. Walked in the second. Was forced out of second on the 6-4 fielder's choice on the ground ball to Ibarra. Bush at 31, and went second, and Martinez at first. One down here, base is loaded. Pitch to Lockett, outside, ball one. So Isaac Lopez showing some command issues now. BIRDVILLE does a good job of being patient at the plate, waiting for their pitch. Cut the lead in half now, trailing 2-1. That swung on. Count evens at 1 to lock it. Right fielder Mason Sigmund waits on deck. Fast check second, comes in with the 1-1 pitch. Curveball misses again. Frustration there from Lopez. Probably thought he had a strike on that pitch, didn't get the call. Be a little frustrating when you don't get those calls. Pretty consistent on both sides of the coin here. Yeah, that pitch misses out. Cats gets away. And in the score is going to be Will Bush. Close throw, but he makes it in time. Tied at 2 after the 2 wild pitches, leads to 2 runs. Rondo stays at second and Martinez at first. They're 1 down. Lockett firmly ahead of the count, 3-1. Pitch swung, fouled back. Bottom third's been good, so the Hawks are able to answer back the 2 runs the Royals put up in the top of the third. Now this one up at 2. Lockett has a full count. Takes it, ball 4. Bases back again, loaded after the walk, back-to-back walks. That might do it for Lopez as coach comes out to talk to him. We'll take a short break. You're watching BIRDVILLE Hawks Baseball on Vype Live.
welcome back. We do have a pitching change. So Manny Salas comes in to pitch for Isaac Lopez. They're going to lift the DH. Tanner Parris is going to take over at third base. Tanner Parris comes in to play first base now. Salas is playing third to first baseman. He'll come in to pitch. Isaac Lopez went 2 1/3, gave up 2 hits, 5 walks. Most of those came in this inning here. 1 strikeout, 2 runs so far. He is responsible for all 3 runners on the base paths right now. As Mason Sigmund comes in and swings and fouls that one. So Ioana at third, Martinez at second, and Corey Lockett at first. Reached on with single, walk. 0-1 pitch. He's off the little floaty curveball up there in the dirt. Count evens at 1. Ioana, another one of those seniors honored today before the game for senior night here at Birdfield. The 1-1 pitch popped up over to Ibarra. He's got a clean play for it. Go 5. Drops it. Tags at third. It's going to be a close play at home. And Ioana's going to be tagged out at home. That's going to do it for the third inning. It was an info flyer, but it's going to be 2 down, and that's going to do it for the third inning. Hawks do pick up 2. Tie this one up at 2. We head to the top of the fourth. You're watching Birdville Hawks Baseball on Vype Live. Head to the top of the fourth, 2-2 our score here. Both teams have bases loaded in their respective halves of the inning, producing 2 runs. And that's where we stand at, 2 here in the top of the fourth. The book on Cameron Ward was 2 innings pitched, gave up 2 hits. 2 walks, 1 strikeout, 2 runs, but only 1 was earned as that ball was hit sharp to third base. Martinez unable to come up with it. Be a leadoff single by Cesar Ibarra. It's a hard shot to Martinez Dofor, but could come up with it cleanly. So Ibarra's on. That's going to bring up Tanner Parris, who's now at first base after the pitching change. He reached on and scored in the third inning after the throwing error by Showalter. Parris, Chirinos, and Salas for the Royals. Pushes that bunt, foul. First, 1 strike here, quick throw over to see if they can get Ibarra back in time. Didn't have much lead at first base. Got to keep it close though. This is a bunting situation here for the bottom of the lineup for the Royals.
is showing bunt early. Healy decides to step off. Reset the count here. Why did I have the pitch you wanted for that bunt show? Fastball goes past him. Strike one. Should be strike two. Ferris down on the count, 0-2. Ibarra on at first after the single and the hot shot to Martinez. No outs here. That pitch is perfect. Strike three, got him looking. Ferris goes down on the strikes. He's going to bring up the right fielder, Justin Chirinos. Single to score to run in the third inning as well. One down now here. Barra at first. 2-2 our score here. Nice night for baseball. That wind that was gusting in, I would say gusting, really blowing in the first couple of innings is non-existent right now. Tends to happen once the sun sets. Trinos. Heading the count, 1-0, feeling quick, snap throw to first base. Again, Barr not really much of a lead. There may be a two steps lead at first base. Just trying to keep him honest there at first base. Ace Torino's shows bunt. A little bit bigger lead now for Ibarra. Pitch down low inside. Torino's heading the count, 2-0. Royals left all the runners on base in that last inning. Had the bases loaded with none out. And was only managed to bring in one run. That popped up to the right side. Ioana was under it, tracks it down, and makes the catch. So two down now here in the top of the fourth. After the pop out to Ioana. Covering up the left fielder, Leo Salas. Salas is 2-for-1 tonight. Grounded out in the first, singled in the third. Knocked in Paris to give the Royals a 1-0 lead. Okay, curveball catches the corner. Nice little curveball there by Phelan. Three strikeouts already. Came in for Cameron Ward in the top of the third. Got all three outs. 0-1 from the sidearm. And that's called a strike. So feeling doing a good job getting ahead of the count. 0-2. Runner on first base with two down here. Or something. The inside or outside corner. Comes back with it, grounded over to Juanes. Over to Ioana, and that's going to do it for the fourth inning. One runner reaches base, no runs score. Gets to the bottom of the fourth, 2-2 our score. Thank you. halfway through this one here at BIRDVILLE. Tie score at 2. Dave Winans is stepping in now. He'll be followed by Alex Showalter, and back to the top of the lineup with the center fielder Ben Brooks. Winans struck out looking in the second inning. Salas, who took over for Lopez. His first pitch misses inside. Little pitch swung on early, foul to the third base side, to the Royals dugout. So count evens at 1. Hawks able to answer back in the third inning. Out their bases a couple of times. They're able to bring in 2 runners. That's where we sit. Knotted up at 2 here in the bottom of the 4th. Lopez struggled with the strikes on the last inning. He's going to bring in Manny Salas and settle things down. They're able to get out of the inning with a fly roll, but throughout Ioannou at third, or excuse me, at home. Kind of saved it for the Royals in the 4th inning, or in the 3rd inning. So Linus goes fishing, misses, and strikeout number 2 for him on the night. That's going to bring up Alex Showalter. Walter 0-1, 0-1 this game. Adding the count 1-0 now. Tips that pitch, count evens at 1. Ben Brooks waits on deck. He started off the 3rd inning with a single, stole 2nd, was thrown out at 3rd base on a fielder's choice play. Manny Salas had some struggles of his own trying to find the strike zone here. Pitch chased, grounded over to Lopez. Lopez cleans it, quick throw over to first base. That's going to be out number 2. So in the steps, Ben Brooks, 2-for-1. Singled, stole the base. .233 in district play. Howard's going to go up a little bit with that single here he had last inning. Waits on that one. Misses high, ball 1. Back to the top of the lineup. He can get on Grant Pert, would be next. There's 2 down here in the bottom of the 4th. Tie score 2-2. That pitch misses low, 2-0. So Brooks ahead in the count. Drives that one in the gap in right field. That's going to be extra bases. Bounce first base. Picked up by Smith Johnson against the wall. And he's in there easily with a stand-up double. So a 2-out double for Brooks. Puts him in scoring position. It's going to be Grant Pert. See if he can drive in a run here. Swing there by Brooks. Just went down and got it. Sent it to the gap and turned that into extra bases. Pert walked in the first, walked in the second, came around to score on the wild pitch in the third. Little Hawks first run of the game. Shot here, grounded over to Lopez, takes a hop, fields it on one hop over to first base, and that'll do it for the bottom of the fourth. One hit, no runs. One run left on base. We head to the top of the fifth. 2-2 our score. Lopez, Manny Salas, and Smith Johnson do up here for the Royals in the top of the fifth. 2-2 our score. Isaac Feeling came in and settled things down in the third inning. He's been on point since then, coming in for Cameron Ward. And as I say that, his first pitch gets away from him and catches Salas in the back, or Lopez in the back. So within the steps, Manny Salas. He's on the hill now, came in for Isaac Lopez in the third inning. Lopez struggled with his command, walking. Three base runners gave up two singles in that inning. Like his counterpart, Feeling, Manny Salas also settled things down for his team. And he pops that one up to left field. That one's a deep drive back to the wall. And that one is off the wall. Lockett tracks it down. It's going to be a ground rule double. The bounce is over. Salas was a deep drive. Saved by the wind not really blowing in as much as it was in the first couple of innings there. We had a pinch runner here for Salas. It's going to be Mason Gray going to pinch run for Salas, helping himself out there. They no out, double. Ground rule double does save the Hawks, as Sebastian Lopez did have to wait at third base. That is the only bright side to that. Lockett took an odd line on that pitch, or on that ball. And they're going to potentially walk Smith Johnson to load the bases here. Bases loaded now. A repeat of the third inning, no outs here.
Marshall Minard comes in to capture. He popped out to second, popped out to third base in the second and walked in the third. And that pitch catches the outside corner. Ball, strike one. Break things open here for the Royals. Hawks playing in at the grass. Thing on the ground is going to be automatic play to home for Will Bush. That pitch, curveball, catches the corner, strike two. So nice pitch there by Phelan. Little breaking ball, caught Minard off target. So 0-2 the count. No outs here on the top of the fifth. Royals looking to regain the lead they had in the third. Now tied at two. Swung on, that's gonna be a hard play at right field to Sigmund. Dives and makes the catch. Tagging at third is Smith Johnson. He'll come in to score. So they're saying in tag. Trying to get Bush's attention to throw it up first. Umpire's saying he did tag. So both of our city attacks, there's not gonna be a field on that play. I didn't see it, I was looking the right field, so. Fan saw it, the player saw it. So Lopez scores on the diving catch by Sigmund. So 3-2, one down here in the top of the fifth. The Royals take the lead back. Johnson at first, Salas at second, or pinch runner at second for Salas. It was Mason Gray. Lopez came around to score on the tag, the phantom tag at third. First pitch hits another batter. Anti pitch and break, so Strickland is on after being hit by the pitch. So bases are loaded again. That's going to bring out manager here to talk to Phelan. We're going to take a short break. You're watching BIRDVILLE Hawks Baseball on Vype Live. Seth Cesar Ibarra in there for the Royals at shortstop. Two for one tonight. Grounded out to third base in the second and singled in the fourth inning. Went down here, bases loaded. He's feeling in a little spot here, showing bunt, the bunt and run as. Gray was taking off with the pitch. Ibarra wasn't able to make contact. Did make contact, just didn't go straight. Royals trying to work the squeeze play there. Martinez in at third base. 1-1 pitch is fouled off the third base side, so Phelan head in the count now, 0-2. One down here.
spot would be what the Hawks need right now. Airplane in, so the first play would be to home. Feeling from the stretch, 0-2. Ground it over to Juanis. Comes to home and gets the out. Try to check and make sure he caught the ball. Gray out at home. So they turned a double play, but Johnson didn't go at second. It's kind of froze there. So that's going to do it for the top of the fifth. We'll talk about it when we come back. BIRDVILLE Hawks coming up in the bottom of the fifth. You're watching Hawks Baseball on Vype Live. All right, we head to the bottom of the fifth. Rich leading this one by a score of 3-2. Odd play of events there. Comes out to the Hawks' favor after the, after Linus went home to Bush. That allowed Barra to get to first. And then the runner at first didn't go to second, which Chris Johnson was at second. So that caused the force at second. So Strickland was at first, didn't go on the play home, stood there. So two runners can occupy the same base at the same time. So they were able to get the second out of that inning and only come away with only giving up one run when they made the first force play to second base. So that's where we stand here in the bottom of the fifth. As Will Bush steps in there, the 1-1 count. Bush singled and reached on by fielder's choice in the third. Came around to score in the two-run inning for the Hawks. They now trail this one by one. They're in the bottom of the fifth. And 2-1 pitch driven to right field for a base hit. Bush is on to lead off the fifth. He's going to bring up Nico Iwanu. Iwanu batting cleanup tonight for the Hawks tonight. Daniel Ashlock will pinch run for Bush. And actually, Ashlock pinch ran for Bush in the third inning as well and came around to score. So that was Ashlock's run for Bush that he scored. So Ashlock in at first. See a pinch run for Bush. And the Iwanu takes a big cut. Got to slow down, trying to make a big hit here as his team is down by one here. Still plenty of baseball to play. Nine outs to work with here for the Hawks, so plenty of spots left here as that ball is grounded up to Lopez. Lopez over to Ybarra, and that pitch is, that ball is out for a double play. So Lopez de Ybarra to Salas for the double play. Actually, that was Paris at first base. This is the base runner now, two down here in the bottom of the fifth. Brandon Martinez steps in there. Lined out to left field in the first and walked in the third inning. So that breaking pitch for ball one. They get on that to bring up the left fielder, Corey Lockett. 1-0 pitch to Martinez. Good eye there, patient. Watch his ball two go by. Got an overflow crowd here. But here tonight on senior night on this Thursday. Playing on a Thursday since tomorrow's Good Friday, so no school, no games tomorrow. I don't know about school, but no games tomorrow. Curveball hung inside, that's fouled off down to third base. Salas coming back in with two inside breaking pitches. Salas with the 2-1 pitch. This is low. Get on, that's going to bring up Corey Lockett, two down now in the bottom of the fifth. Loops one to left field, but that's going to find foul territory. So count sits at 3-2 now. So Bynum gets set again. 3-2 pitch to Bynum, fouls it off to the right side this time. Protected the plate on that one, went on the outside pitch and stayed alive by getting a piece of that one. Bush led off this inning with a single, but got a race on the double play. And that pitch is outside. Two-out walk to Bynum. Officially 0-for-1 on the night with two walks. That's going to allow Corey Lockett to step in there. Officially no at-bats as he's walked twice himself. He gets ahead of that one, fouls it off to the first base side. Lockett can get on, that'll bring up Mason Sigmund, the right fielder, as he waits on deck for his shot. Breaking pitch kind of got away from Salas. Count evens at 1. Salas likes to work a high number of curveballs in there. I'd be surprised if he tries to come back with this one on the inside. Fastball down the middle, swung through. Manny Salas goes ahead in the count. 1-2. Hawks down by 1. Martinez at first base is the tying run here for the Hawks. And pitches into the inside and fouled back. Count stays 1-1, or excuse me, 1-2. Sauce's 1-2 pitch doesn't break, stays high. Count evens at 2. Hawks trying to answer back. They were able to answer back in the third when they were down 2-0. Tied it up at 2. Royals took the lead at the top of this inning. That's where we stand here. 3-2 in favor of the Royals. Hawks trying to tie this one up. Of course, get more out of it. Count locked up. 2-2. Inside. In towards the gap. Smith Johnson giving chase. Gets under it and makes the catch for the third out of the inning. Led to the top of the six. You're watching BIRDVILLE Hawks baseball on Close Vype Live. Top of the six we go. 3-2 our score in favor of the Richland Royals. Deal for the Royals is Tanner Paris now at first base. Justin Chirinos, the right fielder, and Leo Salas, the left fielder. Royals for themselves a tough opponent tonight. They get the playoff shape. So Vreeland comes on to start the top of the sixth. The first pitch is popped up. Linus has it behind the bag and makes the catch for the first out in the sixth inning. So Justin Torino steps in, singled in the third. Came around to score and popped out to first base in the fourth inning. 1-2 on the night. Steps in with one down here at the top of the sixth. Left-handed hitter takes the first pitch for a strike. To Chirinos. Watches that one go outside. Has one of the three scores for the Royals. And nice breaking pitch, swung on it. Just wasn't nothing there for him to hit. Goes down on the count. One ball, two strikes. Salas waits on deck. In the pitch, inside pitch is grounded to the first base side. Feeling back at it now. down here on the six, and that's going to be grounded back up to Showalter over there first, digs it out, and they're going to call him safe. Tough play. Fielding it a go, and Showalter picked it up and just wasn't in time, so Serenos is on with an infield single. Leo Salas, the left fielder. 1-for-2 on the night. 2 ground outs to short and a single in the third inning. Does have an RBI. Knocked in one of the first runs of the third inning for the Royals. Pitches to Salas. Some curveball there. Can't quite catch up to it. So back at the top of the lineup for the Royals. Salas followed by Lopez, and if Lopez can get on, then the other Salas will be up. Pitcher Manny Salas. That pitch is not even close. Serenos will take second on the wild pitch. He had a firm grip on that one, just released it late. Hit the backstop. So the count does run even for Phelan. Came in for Cameron Ward in the third inning after getting the bases loaded, got out of the jam there. Give up any runs. Did give up a run the last inning. That ball has popped up to Brooks at center. Brooks under it. Tagging at second is Lope Chirinos, and he'll move over to third. There are now two outs. In steps Sebastian Lopez. Playing second base tonight for the Royals. Comes in with two outs. The stretch feeling. First pitch to Lopez. Down low. Lopez struck out in the first. Walked in the third, hit by the pitch in the fifth, and scored the lone run in the fifth to give the Royals the lead. That's where we sit, 3-2, and that pitch fouled back. Justin Torino's the runner at third. Royals trying to extend their lead here, up by one, 3-2. So 1-1 pitch, that break stays up. And the count goes to 2-1. Manny Salas waiting on deck. Being a set, 2-1 pitch is popped up to left field, high pitch. Under it is Wynas. Actually got it as Lockett. Finds it with a shuffle move, and that's going to do it for the sixth inning. One hit, no runs. We head to the bottom of the sixth. 3-2 our score.
rally hats are on for the Hawks here. Mason, Sigmund, Gabe, Aquinas, and Alex Showalter, the bottom third, bottom lineup, do appear for the Hawks. Royals leading this one 3-2. First pitch, foul back, hanging a curveball there. Mason popped out to center field in the second and popped out too short on the infield fly rule back in the third inning as he pops up to third base. Strickland giving chase, and looks like he makes the catch in foul territory, and that's going to be the first out of the inning. So nice play there by Jackson Strickland to track that one down and make the catch. Going to get a pinch hitter here for Gabe Aquinas. Ashcroft is going to be pinch hitting. Daniel Ashlock pinch hitting for Winan. Ashlock hit 200 in the season. Has 3 RBIs, 4 singles, and 13 runs scored. Ashlock, his first cuts at the of the night here. Gabe Winan ended his night with 2 strikeouts. Pitch bounces in the dirt. 2-0 to count to Ashlock. Ashlock was a pinch runner for Bush when he got on the first couple of times. He's going to do his part here to help his team out. Heading the count 3-0. Hawks facing their last 5 outs here. The bottom of the 6th. 3-0 pitch to Ashlock. Misses, and he's on base with a... He's got me plenty of times on that one. So the count's 3-1. So Daniel back in there. Still ahead in the count, 3-1. Manny Salas comes back. That pitch is grounded at third base side. Full count now to Ashlock. Manny battling back after getting down to the count 3-0, comes back with the 3-2 pitch. Dug down, popped up to right field. Chirinos giving chase and makes the catch in foul territory for the second out. Second baseman Alex Showalter coming in there now. 0 for 2. Let's see if it can ignite here a 2-out rally. Salas. Fouls off the pitch. Royals did a good job of keeping the Hawks off balance. Hawks have had runners on each inning. 2 in the first, 1-2 in the third, 1-1 in the other innings. And that pitch is lined to center field, so a base hit for Showalter. It's going to be the top of the lineup to come up now. Hawks going to try to work a little two-out magic here in the bottom of the 6th, down by 1. Tying run is on base for the Hawks. By way of Showalter's singles, that's going to bring in Ben Brooks, the center fielder. This team need to put
put together back-to-back hits here. Showalter about a 2-3 step lead at first base. That first pitch down low. Brooks popped out to center in the first, singled in the third, and doubled in the second. Weren't able to get anything going after the leadoff double in the fourth. And he pops that one to Christian Smith-Johnson under it and makes the catch. That's going to do it for the sixth. One hit, no runs. We head to the top of the seventh. 3-2 our score. We head to the last inning here. Manny Sala steps in. Pitcher came in for Isaac Lopez in the third inning. And that settled things down for the Royals. They lead this one 3-2 here. Sala himself, he's walked, struck out, and doubled in the fifth. The ground will double. He's been helping himself out at the plate as he swings through that one and misses for strike one. So through four, Phelan has gotten three strikeouts and only given up one run. And has only surrendered three hits. Out of the count, 0-1 down low, even in the count now. Salas, Christian Smith-Johnson, the center fielder, and Marshall Minard due up here for the Royals here on the top of the seventh inning. Trying to get through this inning as quickly as they can so they can get back to their half of the inning as Salas singles up the middle. So Mason Gray will come on to run for Salas again. Christian Smith-Johnson steps in there, the speedy center fielder. Trying to extend his team's lead here. Up 3-2, up by one. Pops that one straight back and into the street. Phelan looked pretty good after coming on for Cameron Ward in the third inning. Did have a little struggle inning in the fifth. Allowed the Royals to go ahead and take the lead here. 3-2. So Phelan ahead of the count 0-2 to Christian Smith. Pitch inside, went the other way with it. Fair ball, that's gonna be extra bases as Ward Grant
comes Mason Gray comes around. He's going to come home. Come in, throw is going to be to Mountier, and the throw is not in time. So Gray scores on the double by Christian Smith. And the Royals have stretched this lead out to 4-2 now. So 4-2 our score now. One, no outs here in the top of the seventh. That's going to bring up Marshall Minard. Looking to keep this scoring alive here in the seventh inning for the Royals. Goes after that one, fouls it off. Single, double. This inning have given the Royals a 4-2 lead now in the top of the seventh. Hawks have rallied before. And you get one out here as he swings to that one. Count now 1-2. A couple of weeks ago where they came back and won it in the bottom of the seventh. The Mustangs. The 1-2 is swung on early and driven foul. Manner saw the pitch he liked, just got ahead of that one. Fouls it off down the right. Check of second, 1-2 pitch. Manner lets it go, 2-2. Manner popped out in the second, walked in the third, and lined out to right field in the fifth inning. Even in the count, 2-2, no outs. That pitch doesn't break in, stays out, count runs full. Smith Johnson on at second after the RBI double. Feeling a bluff move to second. So he'll reset. He can get an out here, that 3-2 pitch. Brings him up, caught him looking, so strike three. Took a while on that one. I won't have to wait for us to add anything. So we haven't seen eye to eye today. That's going to be the first out for the Hawks. Jason Strickland steps in. Phelan hit him in the fifth, struck him out in the third, and he grounded out in the second. Pitch is fouled all the way back. Officially 0-2 for the night for Jackson, or Strickland. Jackson Strickland. Man with two last names. Down on the count early, 0-1. Look at Christian Smith. Popped up. Martinez under it. Should have this one for the second out, and he does. Feeling for one more here. Cesar Saibara steps in. Try to get out of this inning with minimal damage. After the single and double, allowed a run to score, and the Royals are going to stretch out their lead to 4-2. Here comes set. Curveball gets away behind Ibarra, and that'll allow Smith Johnson to get to third. Two down, kind of a moot point there. They can focus on Cesar Ibarra, the shortstop here now. Ibarra grounded out, singled, and reached on a fielder's choice back in the fifth inning. Looking to drive in Smith Johnson, who's 90 feet away at third, and stretch out the team's lead. Pops up, coming in hard as Lockett under it is actually going to be. Hawks have it for the third out of the inning. We're going to head to the heart of the lineup. Last chance for the Hawks here in the bottom of the seventh. You're watching Birdville Hawks Baseball on Vype Live. Birdville down to the last three outs here, trailing this one 4-2 as we head to the bottom of the seventh. Royals loaded the bases a couple of times in the third inning, managed two runs out of that one. Isaac Phelan came in to calm things down and get things back on track for the Hawks. Bottom of that inning, they were able to load the bases themselves a couple of times, managed to score a couple of runs and tie it up at the bottom of the third. Went scoreless in the fourth, and in the fifth inning, the Royals took the lead again, 1-0 after a fielder's choice double. And stretched out their lead here on the top of the seventh after the double and single to lead off the top of the seventh. That's where we stand, 4-2. In favor of the Richland Royals, looking to take both games at this home-and-home series. Hawks trying to snap their little mini one-game losing streak and get back in the winning ways of things. Trying to get win number 20 of the year. The duo for the Hawks is Grant Pert, Will Bush, and Nico Iwanu. So the heart of the lineup coming up now for the Hawks. Down by two, so they need some base runners here. 2-0 to Pert. Swings at that one. That's the tip of it, and he's going to ground out to Paris at first. And that's going to be one down for the Hawks now, playing with their last two outs here. Bring up Will Bush, singled in the first. Fielder's choice. Ashlock pinch ran and scored for him in the third and singled in the fifth. But was forced out on the double play. So Bush has been on base all three times. He's come up to the plate. That's really what they're needing right now is base runners. So Bush is going to do his good job. He leads the team and getting on base. Visitor's side of the stadium doesn't like that pitch. Bill digs in with the wide open stance here. 1-0 to Will. You have a new pitcher for the Royals. Smith Johnson does come in to pitch.
see who took a spot out in center field. Too far for me to see, and that pitch catches the corner. So Smith Johnson ahead in the count now. One ball and two strikes. One down here in the bottom of the seventh. Hawks down by two. 1-2. Doesn't quite break, kind of slips out of Johnson's hand. Count runs even at two. Nico Iwanu, first baseman batting cleanup, is on deck and waiting. Smith Johnson with the sign he likes. And again, pitch misses outside. The inconsistency out of Smith Johnson. He's had a couple of good pitches and a couple of not so good pitches that just didn't break at the right spot. Just didn't have that spin on it to break. This count is now full. And that pitch is driven the right field. Back goes Chirinos for it. Over his head. That's going to be double, two bases. As Will Bush is going to be in there with a stand-up double. He went out double here in the bottom of the seventh. And the Hawks getting what they needed, and that's a base runner. Nico Iwanu now with the opportunity here to bring in Bush. He'll stay on the run as Ashlock. Danny Ashlock is now in the game. So Iwanu, chance here to knock in a run. Down by two. So in rally to the Royals, the runner on second really doesn't matter. Iwanu is representing the tying run at the plate. One down, Bush at second after the double. Iwanu popped out to left, singled in the third, and grounded in to shortstop as he fouls that one off to the third base side of things. Count evens at one. Hawks need two, as you can see. Bino Martinez waits on deck. Another foul ball to the right side. Keep saying right side, left side. Stage left, stage right. So 1-2 now, one down. One, two pitch. Swung on and missed. He went chasing on that one. And he's now the second out of this inning. Up to Bino Martinez now. Comes in with two outs. He line out to left in the first, walked in the third, and walked in the fifth. Comes in representing the tying run. Will Bush on second after the double. Smith Johnson swung through, fouled back, and strike one to Bynum. Bynum can keep the inning alive. That'll bring up Corey Lockett. So either way, the Hawks want to see Corey Lockett come up. The 0-1 pitch, Martinez down low, misses ball one. Johnson and a check of the wristband to make sure he has the correct sign. Get set, high set, and 1-1 pitch. Good curveball, called a strike. Put that pitch in a nice spot there on the corner and hits the call here. So the Hawks down to their final strike. Martinez down 1-2 in the count. Will Bush at second. Martinez calls time to get set. both ends of the home and home series here. 1-2 pitch, outside misses. The count evens up at 2. Hawks came into the series, we're in a 13-game winning streak. Russ trying to put him on the wrong end of a 2-game losing streak. 2-2 pitch, swung on a miss, and that's going to do it. Royals win this one by a score of 4-2. So the Hawks are for their second loss in district play. Fall to 8-2 in district, 19-4-1 overall. Still hold first spot over Denton Ryan. They did win that series, took both ends of that series, so up by 3 games on it, 2 games by Denton Ryan, or 3 games since they had that head-to-head matchup. Puts the Royals 2 games back now of the Hawks. That's going to do it. So Richland wins this one by a score of 4-2. Watching BIRDVILLE Hawks baseball on Vype Live. Thank you, everybody, and have a nice night.